Was it recording?
Let's
take a picture.
This is like what character I'm doing stuff on. This is going to be the pattern.
And it goes into the shadow, so it gets stopped. And then the next section is explaining. So it's not like
he said turn it on, it was already on. Wait, there's a tire.
It's close to tire.
Watch both tires.
We've not got the accelerometer code on it yet. The accelerometer code will automate it to keep it in the straight line. You see, you cover the LDR at the front, Grace, try that. Stops yourself. So that's it.
Get a face.
Come on now. Give a return.
PW intern's really good for just connecting like that.
Gonna be.
I was deliberately turning it off, of course. It's definitely drifting left a wee bit.
The bones.
Are you recording?
It's gonna drive himself back into a straight line.
The bones of accelerometer correction. Obviously,
it's not properly calibrated.
It seems more.
It's trying to drive himself back to this angle. That's going to change the actual set point, but you know what way he's facing, and he'll turn back to drive in a straight line.
Nicholas!
So the magnets are pretty strong, so you just. Well, I'll demonstrate putting them on the wall at a bit of an angle.
It should correct itself now.
And then if I reset the Arduino, it should drive itself back into a straight line once it turns on. So once that stops flashing, it turns itself back to a straight line and then drives up in a straight line. Right now all I'm getting it to do to demonstrate this for you was drive for 5 or 6 seconds and then stop, at which point it changes back to remote control and I can control it, I can drive it about. You see if I hold it straight right now, it kind of, it's right now it's actually going in a fixed straight line. If I let go of the controller and drive it all the way to the top, it stops just before it reaches the top because it senses that it's got dark. That's not particularly interesting anymore, but it could be like doing wind turbines, so you'd have to turn around. If John was a wind turbine, we could respect him.
That's just what he was doing last time. He's setting one of the wheels to full pelt.
And the magic happens. Also, go forward. So, as you can see, it's not incredibly fast, but it's pretty consistent. It's not losing the line all that much. Taking corners fairly well, changing radius of curvature, manages the crossovers, even slightly rough terrain. Yeah. I'm afraid that's about as exciting as it's going to get.
Funny just those wee ones, you know, the hooks that you have on the other one. I guess I could tap it.
Move your hand underneath. That's alright. Might come up.
Is it to change the boundaries of these values so that it can tell what one is good and what one is bad?
That's a lot better, isn't it?
Okay, so you have to, as I said, you have to start the program manually, but then you can disconnect it and then just give just let it go and it will flip across and hopefully should be taking pictures as it goes. And the LEDs on here, which change colour based on what it thinks the sleepers are like, so we'll do one run and one run back and we'll show you the results.